Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus, we praise you. Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, we adore you. Jesus, we glorify you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let us praise and worship and invoke the Holy Spirit into our hearts.
Spirit, come and have your way. Have your way. As we lay aside our own desires, sweep across our hearts with holy fire. Have your way. This is
today, as we are begin to meditate upon the gospel, we listen to a gospel passage. In the gospel of Saint Matthew, chapter 8, verse 1 onwards, let us listen to this gospel passage.
When Jesus came down from the mountain, a large crowd followed him. Then a leper came forward. He knelt before him and said, "Sir, if you want, you can make me clean." Jesus stretched out his hand and touched him and said, "I want you to be clean again." At that very moment, the man was cleansed from his leprosy.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
A beautiful incident is being narrated in the Gospel of Saint Matthew, chapter 8, verse 1 onwards. As Jesus was coming down from the mountain, a great multitude of people were around him. Among them, one leper. He came forward and knelt before Jesus, and he's asking him, "Lord, if you wish, you can make me clean." And Jesus says, "I want you to be clean." And Jesus touches him, and he's immediately cured. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The brothers and sisters, today we are going to meditate upon this topic. If we want to be clean, we have to be touched by Jesus. And only Jesus touches you will be healed. And that is one of the most important thing today that should touch our heart too. Because today many people run here and there telling that we do not have an experience of God. And be sure, unless and until Jesus touches you, you will never be transformed. You will never get changed. Today people want a change in their hearts, but the problem is that they do not allow themselves to be touched by Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Why? If Jesus touches a person, definitely he or she will be transformed, and she or he has to renounce so many bad things or bad habits which he or she owns. And people are not prepared for that. And that is the reason why there is no transformation or no lasting changes in the people, those who listen to the word of God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Once I was conducting a retreat in a parish, a gentleman came to me and said, "Father, I won't attend your retreat. I don't attend any of the retreats." I said, "Why? Why don't you do that? Why don't you listen to the word of God?" He says, "If I listen to the word of God, I have to make changes in my life. And I don't want to lose the pleasures that I get by doing wrong things." Once a person is touched by Jesus, he has to put away the old way of life and he has to become something new, somebody new. And these people do not want, because they are afraid that they will lose the pleasures or the happiness which they were getting in the past. My brothers and sisters, be sure they are to be touched by Jesus. So what do you have to do? Here we see the man who was there. He was a leper and he wanted to be touched by God, and he got an inspiration to come and kneel before Jesus. And now in certain cases, we know our brothers and near and dear ones, they are not intended, or they don't want to go near Jesus. Now what can we do? We should pray for them. We should pray for those children. We should pray for those parents who are not interested in going to Jesus, who are not interested in spiritual activities. Then through our prayer, there will be a change in them so that they may be able to go to Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The book of Proverbs chapter 29 verse 19 says, "By words alone you cannot change a person."
A slave is not corrected by words. Even if he understands, he will take no notice.
Praise the Lord. What does it mean? Even if he receives this advice, he need not make a change. We have advised so many people in our past life. How many have changed? Unless and until Jesus touches, there won't be change in the persons. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's the word of God says, by words alone, a person cannot be corrected. Even if he understands your advice, even if he takes heed of his advice, he may not make a change in that person, because Jesus has to touch that person. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When we come to the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9, there we see St. Paul. St. Paul was such a strong man who was trying to destroy Christianity. He wanted to destroy every Christian who take the name of Jesus. And such a staunch person, an extremist would say, who wanted to destroy Christianity and Jesus. And that man, on his way to Damascus, we see Jesus is touching him. And once Jesus touches, and he just fell on the ground, and then his eyes were blinded, and we know what happened. The person who was just wanted to destroy the Christianity, who wanted to destroy every single person who take the name of Jesus, he was transformed, and he became a zealous missionary who was just going ahead of Jesus, who was preparing the way of Jesus, who was preaching the way of the word of God without any fear, who was ready to take up any kind of trials and persecutions for the sake of very same Jesus whom he wanted to destroy. Hallelujah.
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 And this transformation was a lasting change. And dear brothers and sisters, this is what we need in our life. Allow yourself to be touched by Jesus. Allow yours to be touched by Jesus. And you want all those who touch Jesus and all those who have been touched by Jesus were transformed, and there were miraculous changes in their lives. Hallelujah.
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 I remember another incident. Once, dear brothers and sisters, I was contacting a retreat for 5 days for the youth. And you know what happened? In the retreat, there was a gentleman who was of 21 years of old. He never listened to any of the talks. He used to go around wandering here and there. He wouldn't come correctly for the mass, and he was not at all interested. And when I talked to him, because after 2 days, when I noticed that he was not at all listening to these services, I called him and spoke to him so calmly. "My dear child, why are you here? Why do you want to waste your time? I saw you without praying, wandering here and there. Why don't you attend the retreat?" He said, "Father, I don't believe in Jesus. I don't believe in these practices because the compulsion of my parents, I have just reached here. I want to just finish it off. I want to get it out of this house at the earliest. And I'm just waiting for the last 2 days to get it over." And whatever I said, he couldn't grasp or he couldn't obey. He told, "I'm not interested. Please leave me alone." And that was what he said. And finally, I knew that my words or my advices cannot make a change in him. Dear brothers and sisters, believe me, on the previous day of adoration, I, in a very special way, took his name and spoke to his prayer. I prayed for him to Jesus. So 2 days are completed. It's now going to be the last 2 days. And there is no change in him. Please touch him. Please give him a spirit in him so that he may be changed. And I asked the Lord in a very special way for this person. And the third day was completed. There was nothing happened. And the final day, I remember almost 5:30 in the morning, the adoration was going on. I was just in the chapel and this gentleman came inside. He told me, I was there praying. He was just there sitting for a few minutes. Then he came to me and, "Father, would you please pray for me?" I said, "Of course, I can pray." And you know, my brothers and sisters, what happened? The moment I started praying over him, he started shivering. He was just shivering like anything and just screaming out. I was wondering what is happening, but something was happening in him. Meanwhile, I called one or two people who to help me, and they just caught hold of him. And as well as praying, was shivering and shivering, he just fell down. He fell down. He started praising the Lord. He started saying hallelujah. And after 5 minutes, he just got up and he said, "Father, I want to make a good confession." I said, "What made you?" "I don't know, Father. I want to make good confession." My dear brothers and sisters, within no time, he made a very beautiful, perfect confession. And you know what happened? This man, after the retreat, the last day, he was totally transformed. He was one of the zealous person who went out with so much faith in his heart. Hallelujah.
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 So I remember so many incidents. I have preached to thousands of people, have preached to hundreds of people, and there I have not found any change unless until they are touched by Jesus. And today, the Word of God says to you and me, dear brothers and sisters, let us just rethink about your life. Have you been touched by Jesus? If you are a person who is touched by Jesus, there will be definitely a change and transformation in your life. You cannot go along with the same old way of life. Hallelujah.
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 So, dear brothers and sisters, today, let us pray. Lord, I want to be touched by you. Just like the leper said, "Lord, if you wish, you can touch me." Oh, Lord, we need your grace to be touched by you. And so, let us pray for many people who are around you, Lord, who has not got the touch of Jesus, so that they may become true witnesses, they may become true believers in Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's stand up. Let's close our eyes for a moment. Oh Lord, so many years since we were listening to the Word of God, but we have been never touched by Jesus. And we know that is the reason why we remain the same. Our Lord, all those who were touched by Jesus, all those people who were touched by Jesus had long-lasting changes in their lives. They were ready to renounce the old way of life. They become new creation. And today we ask you, Lord, touch us. We ask you for, we pray for all those people, brothers and sisters who are around you, who have not got a touch from you. Lord, you touch them so that the Spirit of Jesus may make conversions and changes in their lives. Let us praise and worship the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, we thank you and praise you. Oh Lord, send forth your Spirit. Lord, touch each and every one of us who listen to this prayer. Oh Lord, touch and heal everyone. All those who touch, we have our own leprosy in our hearts. We have our leprosy of our pride, our anger, our wrong emotions. Oh Lord, give us the grace to be touched. We want to renounce all these things. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh Holy Spirit, come and dwell in our hearts. It's your house. We welcome you to our hearts. We welcome into our house. Hallelujah. Praise and glory, 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 glory.
This is your we welcome you, Lord, we welcome you. This is your heart. We welcome you today. Hallelujah, we praise you, Lord. Lord, we worship you, Lord, we thank you, Lord. Lord, we bless your name. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, Holy Spirit of God, we welcome you. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Together, clapping the Lord, let us praise and worship the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're all together lovely, all together worthy, all together wonderful to me. To say that you're my God, you're all together lovely, all together worthy, all together wonderful to be.
Almighty Father, we thank you, Jesus.
We bless your name, Jesus.
Jesus, we know that you are truly present in this Eucharistic. Lord, we know your love is without boundaries. Lord, we are weak and fragile, but your love encompasses us. Lord, as we are here today, we worship your name. We praise your name. We glorify you, Lord. With the holy host we pray. With the angels and saints, we bless your name. Lord, you are the one who does all wonders in our lives. Unless and until you touch us, we can never become a transformed person. Today, Lord, as we are at your feet, proclaiming your glory, we surrender ourselves totally and fully to you. Lord, you are the mightiest Savior. You are the one who sustains us even today. You are the one who protects us. Whatever we have is a gift from you, Lord. As we are here, Lord, we acknowledge our weaknesses. We acknowledge our sins. We are weak, Lord. We have been unfaithful to you, Lord. Today we ask your grace. Help us, Lord. Give us all the graces we need. Apart from you, we can do nothing. Oh Jesus, all those who touched you and all those who have been touched by you were healed. And the leper, he came and asked, Lord, if you wish, you can heal me. And you stretched your arms and touched him and healed him. Oh Lord, we have got different types of leprosy in our lives. We have got anger. We have got pride. We have got short-tempered nature. We are craving after worldly pleasures. These are different kinds of leprosies that is affecting us. Well, we want to get rid of all these things. We want to become clean again. And if you wish, you can do that. Please touch me, Lord. Please make me clean, Lord. Oh Lord, make my heart and mind and body pure once again. We ask this to you, Lord. Raising the hands up to heaven. Let's praise and thank the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh Lord, touch me. Oh Lord, heal me. Oh Lord, me, give me victory. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let all the bondages be in Jesus' name. Let all the bondages be gone in Jesus' name. Let us praise and worship the Lord. Hallelujah. As we praise and worship, let all the worries be gone in Jesus' name. Lord, the uncontrollable emotions be gone in Jesus' name. Let all the sickness be gone in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, give us new grace. Let us raise the hands up to heaven as we are preparing ourselves to receive the blessing. Let us raise hands and praise and thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh Jesus, we praise and thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Everyone be blessed.